My name is Michaela Voss, and I'm the medical director at the Eating Disorder Center at Children's Mercy Kansas City. Starvation is the body's state when it has not received enough nutrition to account for all the things it needs to do day to day. Starvation can be acute, meaning for only a short time, like a 24-hour fast, or chronic, meaning for multiple months or longer. It can also be mild, moderate, or severe. Because starvation happens in different ways to different people, you cannot always tell just by looking. The body might look completely normal, or it may show some outward signs of starvation. But first, why does starvation happen, and what exactly is it? Starvation is not about how much or how little food you eat. It's about the balance between what your body needs and what it actually gets. Starvation is any time that the energy balance between the nutrition you give your body and the energy you use up is negative. In other words, the energy you put in is less than the energy you put out. Think of a long-distance runner. Because they are using a ton of energy in their sport, if they ate the same as if they were just resting, they would not eat enough and their body would be in starvation. They have to eat more to keep that balance. When starvation occurs, the body responds with stress signals, and we often call this response starvation mode. These responses are the body's attempt to survive by trying to save as much energy as it can until the famine or perceived famine is over. Because our body does not know the difference between an intentional starvation, such as an anorexia nervosa, or unintentional starvation, such as famine, it responds exactly the same way to both scenarios. There are many ways in which the body can respond when it's in starvation mode. The main thing the body does is slows everything down, because if the body works more slowly and less often, it will not use as much energy. So think about a bear who is hibernating. While hibernating, it does not use as much energy as it does when it's moving around in the summer and hunting for food. Unfortunately, or fortunately, we are not bears. We do not hibernate, and our body is not prepared for such a state. However, our bodies learn from being in a starvation mode. So the next time the body feels threatened by starvation, even if it's a brief fasting session or a slight energy imbalance, it remembers those lessons and goes straight back into starvation mode. This is one of the reasons it is so important to maintain in the middle of your target weight range. It's to prevent all of the health risks associated with the dangers of starvation. Thankfully, almost all the changes the body goes through during starvation mode are reversible. With proper nutritional rehabilitation, the body will recover its lost muscle, start pumping blood and energy to all parts of the body, including the hands and feet, the GI tract, and the brain. Unfortunately, there is some irreversible damage. Because puberty and growth occur within a set time frame, it is impossible to make the bones as strong as they would have been without being in a starvation mode. This means there will always be an increased risk of fracture for anyone whose body goes through starvation mode. Nutrition is essential to support the body's ability to grow, learn, and recover. With full treatment, a teen suffering from a restrictive eating disorder can return to a healthy physical state and lead a long, normal life.